Hey guys, welcome back. It's M.
P7.
This is Key here.
And this is Rush, the Jamaican in the building, aka Blonde Dread. Wagwan, our beautiful people. What's good out there?
Most definitely. Now we're back with Decadence, episode 5. I know we left it with episode 4, where Kaburagi was trying to persuade her to not go into the fight in the nest.
When she just
officially joined the power. When he found out from a friend of his that they plan on, you know, the humans being, the power being wiped out, and the avatars taking most of the glory.
Yes.
So.
And
he
don't
didn't
want her
to be part of the cap. The casualties. And even her friend doesn't like the fact that she's part of the power now. You know, everybody who cares, well, two people that care about her.
Don't want her to go and fight, but she
wants.
Don't
fight because she's a
human.
Well, she's a human and she also has a disability. You know?
And they don't want her to die.
No.
Or they don't want her to fight either.
But she was good when she had first got into the field the first time.
Because she got the new arm thing and all that stuff.
And she took the time to be patient, collect her thoughts. Actually show people how she, you know, really played out.
I'm not saying she's not good. Nobody's not saying that she's not good.
No.
She's definitely
good.
You get me?
But the nest is being battling a whole
lot
of gadolls.
You get me? And she's new. She's good, but she's new because this is her.
She's a rookie.
Yeah, her third outing actually.
No.
Second.
Well, technically third.
Yeah, well, you can say third because the first one was when she was cleaning the what's his name?
The ship.
The Decadence. Right, and the second time was when he was training her.
Yeah, a couple of times.
Right.
Yeah.
And then this more likely is gonna be the third time that she's actually going into like a real,
well,
somewhat like
a battle.
This is definitely a real battle that she.
Oh, okay.
You get me?
All right. So let's see what episode 5 will bring.
What did the 5 say to the face? Remember, I didn't say the hand. I said the 5. She's not wrong. Getting into a battle, my girl.
Mostly avatars anyway.
From one of them.
From one? No, it's mostly people.
No, I'm talking about one god doll.
Oh, okay. That's the alpha one.
That's the way you gotta do it. That's exactly how you gotta do it. Right to the mouth now. Come on, come on, come on. Move, 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 move.
To hide himself.
Lady just didn't tell you. These young people just want to leave without thinking.
The same thing that the god told him.
Yes.
But they don't know that.
Chamber. No, that's a big one. No, that's a, maybe the alpha. Yeah, that's definitely the alpha.
But they was supposed to kill that one. That's what he said. I think if you kill that one, that the bigger one awakens.
Mm-hmm.
That one's that big.
Yes.
They thought that that was like the end of the day. But he already told a peaceful never come. Ghosts in the night.
Really? That's the way you look?
Something out of Dragon Ball Z.
Wow. Pop right back up.
So what do you think of this?
Of this one? This episode? With the young girl trying to
throw herself?
I didn't like it. She knew it. She I understand.
They always try to do the what young characters.
Yeah, I understand where she's trying to go. But at her skill level and at her skill set, no. You're not ready yet. Definitely not ready. He didn't do nothing. He didn't do a dent. You get me? And I'm
was all Kabara?
So that's it. I just wanna say that. If the teacher didn't come out or our master didn't come out to come and help the pupil, she would have definitely died.
Mm-hmm.
And furthermore, if the other older teammate that was on her side, was on her team, if she didn't jump in front of her,
she would have gone.
And this is new too. Some new stuff just happened because now we can see that some of these, what do you call them? The
avatars?
Not avatars.
Cyborgs, that's what they call them.
Well, the monsters are all the god dolls. There we go. They can regenerate, and they're smart enough.
Some of them,
and they're smart enough to pull the stake out. You get me? And send it right back at them, which I didn't thought they would be able to do, but now you see they can do. And just to look at it too, maybe these god dolls are what we're seeing is not really dangerous. They're only dangerous when they're in the avatar mode or when the world.
They need their blood.
Right.
Green oxygen they call.
Yes, the run and the fuel for the for decadence.
Mm-hmm.
You get me? So they have to kill
and
them regardless.
And for the cyborgs as well.
So they have to kill them regardless, or else they're gonna turn around and kill the cyborgs, because when the veil was lifted, right, you saw the gadol. They were very peaceful.
The gadols are peaceful, but the humans, the tempers, they thought that was like the main. Bigness.
But it's not.
But it wasn't. That whole thing was illusion that they was trying to hide from them. The avatars knew. You saw how they were.
Mm-hmm.
The difference between the cyborgs' reaction to what they saw and to what the humans saw. They was like, so we're not done?
Nope. Not even halfway done.
And he already told it before. It's a never-ending story. You're going to continuously fight it. That's what they were trying to hide. And so I'm like, I'm still trying to figure out if this is supposed to be a game for them, or they were supposed to have a storyline for the humans to make them feel like, hey, we're living in peace right now, no more gad dolls, yada yada yada. So I don't know.
Yeah, well, we gotta watch this and see how this plays out some more.
We got a few
more episodes before the end of the season, so.
I wanna see what happened with Kabaragi. Did his avatar, the avatar that his housing and his body in get
killed?
Ended?
I don't want him to die because he still got a lot more to teach her. You get me?
And she's going to try to find him, like, where are you? Or something like that.
Because
I feel like they're going to wipe out his memory, too.
They
reboot him.
They didn't try that before.
They were trying to do that.
They were trying before, and it didn't work, so I don't know if they're going to do that. They only had the option to just kill him or put him to work somewhere even more remote that he don't speak to nobody or do nothing to nobody but apart from going around and take out these bugs, because he's the only one that we know of right now that's going around and taking out the bugs out of the human.
Yeah, that was his job.
Well, it's
when he got
job.
Demoted, you might say.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And you see, he got some sick skills on. So, like, when he go past his limiter and his eyes and start turning red, he just go ballistic. He's out there, you get me? He's a killing machine. He's a one-man band, you know?
Yeah, you're right about that. Anything else you want to say about that?
No, that's it for right now. Until episode 7.
Yeah, guys.
Can't really wait. You get me?
No, this is 2v6.
Oh.
Remember, this is episode 5.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Episode 6. I can't wait to see episode 6. But I forgot to say, what did the hand say to the face?
You did say that in the beginning.
I know.
Mm-hmm. Alright guys, we're gonna end this video here. Thanks for watching.
Most definitely, and please guys, check it out, alright? Check out Decadence, you know.
Most definitely. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up.
And please drop a comment.
Yeah. And if you like the content that we put on this channel, please subscribe down below.
And please,
I know you saw me scratch my butt. It was itching right now. But yeah, subscribe down below.
And please hit that notification bell so you can stay up to date with our latest and greatest videos and content, because we do put out a lot of videos and content out there, and we want you to stay up to date with the thing that is in me.
Most definitely.
One time.
Please remember to tell a friend.
To make a friend.
To keep a friend.
So we all can be friends.
Yes, me.
Big up to Real Reality Team, man. Yes, me. Big up to my partner right here, Burgundy Dredge, aka Key. Big up to myself, Blondie Dredge, Rush. Yes, me. In the building. Big up to all of you, my viewers and subscribers, for sticking with us and staying with us and actually watching and commenting on our videos and leaving comments down below of stuff that you want us to do, guys. Thumbs up to y'all. You see me? Definitely.
Most definitely. And we'll see you guys in the next one.
Catch you in the flippity flip. And remember, pretty soon coming up, we're going to have a surprise for y'all, guys. You see me? We forgot to tell y'all about the beautiful surprise that we're going to be having for y'all. Hopefully, one or two of y'all. You see me?
All right, guys. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Peace and love, guys.